Everyone, in my previous lectures, I have covered few points of modern developments in carding. These are short feed to card, unidirectional feed, use of carding segments under tickering, use of carding segments around the cylinder. Today I am going to discuss the remaining points of modern developments in carding. Apron doffing. The card web stripped from the doffer by the doffing device is freely suspended over a distance of 30 to 50 cm in conventional cards, which would fall apart or say damaged at delivery speed of 200 to 300 meters per minute used for high performance cards. The web on such cards must be condensed into sliver while still located within the detaching device. This can be achieved by using web guide plates, transversely disposed two counter rotating aprons, or a circulating band carrying the web to the one side of the card. If we see the position on card, suppose this is doffer, we are taking top view, then doffing device, includes stripping roll, then redirecting roll, then pair of cross roll, then the web comes out and it is condensed through trumpet followed by pair of calendar rolls. So this is the reason where web is freely suspended and there will be chances of damage for high performance cards, because in high production cards doffer speed is increased and that increases the air currents, and air currents can damage the web. So that's why in the modern cards, either we use two counter rotating aprons like this, which will deliver the web to the trumpet in the middle this way, or we can use a circulating band which will deliver web at the one end of card. So this is the way by which we can rectify the problem of damage to web in the free space. This device can be equipped with online monitoring of naps also. So we can take the advantage of this device by applying online monitoring device also in this region. Next point is higher cylinder speed. In high performance cards, the role of cylinder speed is very important to maintain an adequate number of wire points per fiber at higher throughput. As we have discussed earlier also, that in high production cards, to deal with high throughput, we have to increase the cylinder speed up to an optimum level, apart from using additional carding segments around cylinder. The cylinder speed is accordingly increased to maintain adequate fiber individualization. Conversely, a higher cylinder speed for a given production rate improves fiber individualization and therefore the yarn quality. The improvement in fiber individualization occurs not only due to greater number of wire points per fiber, but also due to reduced cylinder load. Reduced cylinder load obviously means more number of fiber free cylinder wire points available for carding. So obviously that will enhance the carding of fibers or individualization of fibers. Cylinder speed has reached up to 600 rpm or above in modern cars. So that is a great advantage to increase number of wire points per fiber. Next point is high performance card wire. The first development which made a drastic change in the car productivity was the introduction of metallic wire in 1965. Before this, only flexible wire points were in use, and with flexible wire points the main problem was there is a limit to increase the speed of card, as well as there is more chances of accumulation of short fibers and trash in wire points. Therefore a frequent stripping was required. So by introduction of metallic wire points, this not only increased the productivity but also reduced card waste and eliminated frequent card stoppages to strip the cylinder and doffer. Further improvement in metallurgy and design of card wire, such as optimizing wire height, wire angle and wire pin density, led to further increase in productivity and improvement in yarn quality, especially in reduction of nap level. If you see the metallurgy of wire points on cylinder and doffer, earlier it was only high carbon steel for the wire points, but nowadays we use high carbon steel alloyed with chromium, tungsten and vanadium. It increases the strength of wire points, and that way the sharpness of wire point is maintained for its whole lifespan, and that reduces the requirement of grinding, and that way we can easily optimize the design of card wire, especially the wire point height. For Licorin, leading edge of wire point is made of tool grade steel, or we can say we use bi-component material. If you see the Licorin wire points, these are sawtooth wire points like this. So here the leading edge is made of this tool grade steel. There is maximum stress over the Licorin wire points, because Licorin wire points have to deal with the bigger size of flocs. So by using tool grade steel, their efficiency will improve, as well as they will become durable. Next point is online monitoring of naps. The naps are serious blemish in yarns and need continuous checking. In the past, only offline testing of naps in the card web was performed, in which the web was collected from a running card onto a blackboard and covered with a glass sheet, and then we count the number of naps to calculate the nap count. Nap count is number of naps per 100 square inch. Now some manufacturers have come out with inbuilt devices to display the nap count of the card wire. I mentioned earlier in the region where we apply apparent doffing, we can use this device also. Therefore, immediate action can be taken to prevent excessive naps from passing into the card sliver and ultimately into the yarn. Now looking to advantages of this device, it has now become a standard feature of modern cards. then integrated grinding system, which is known as IGS system. This system, incorporated in the latest models of Ritter card, automatically grinds the cylinder to maintain optimum sharpness of wire point over its entire lifespan. All this takes place when a card is running, and that too without operator intervention. An associated software determines the need for grinding and then activate the grinding process. You know, in the grinding process, we have to stop the card, clean the card, and then we put the grinding roller over the card at front plate region, and then grinding takes place. But with this IGS system, now there is no need to stop the card, and it is totally microprocessor based, and without operator intervention it grinds the cylinder wire points like this. Suppose this is the cylinder. Below the cylinder, this device is placed, and whenever grinding is required, which will be based on number of naps, as we have online monitoring of naps. So as soon there is sudden increase in naps, this IGS system will be activated, or it can be set in the card. The frequency can be set, so after a certain amount of production or throughput, it will be activated. So when it is required, or it will, this is side view of card. Suppose this is a device. So whenever it is required, it will take a traverse from one end to other end and again come to the normal position. This is basically not a grinding in true sense, because in grinding sparks will take place, and in IGS we don't stop the production. Fibers are there on the cylinder surface. Basically it is a just polishing effect over the wire points. Because of improved metallurgy, the wire point, they don't become blunt. Only some coating occurs on the tip of wire points, and that will be polished away with the help of this IGS system. So that way their effectiveness will be maintained throughout its lifespan. Now we are left with only auto labeling at card. I will cover this point in my next lecture. Thank you very much.